This is my railing that I just installed. It's an old railing that I reinstalled them. And what I want to show you, I want to actually paint it. And I just want to show you what I'm doing here. I'm actually in the process of grinding the rusted from this place. If you can see here, you will see how rusted is this metal iron or railing. Okay, and here I actually already grind it, so I'll show you here. So I want to show the process what I'm doing, because you will definitely need to grind. You can use a iron brush or steel brush, but it's not going to work properly and it will take you a long time to remove this kind of rusted. Look at that here, how rusted it is, and here. So you have to really remove the rust before you starting painting. I want to show you how I'm doing it. This is another area that you can see need to be grinded. As you can see the difference here, I already grinded. And you can see how nice it looks. And here I didn't grind it, so look at it look like. Now if you're going to paint something like that, it won't last for a while and it would look very bad. This is very smooth, this is very rough here. Let me show how I'm actually grinding this metal. So what I'm using this grinder, and here it's actually DeWalt grind, and it attaches here, you can see it, and it's high speed, so let me show you how I'm doing it. And you see, after I grind here, I have to go from the other direction because I want to remove everything. So I'm going to show you from another direction what I'm doing here. I'll get you closer to the area to show you. As you can see, it looks very smooth, and you can see the metal. That's very important. After I'm going to grind all this area, I'm going to use a metal brush to remove the rest. So remember, if you're going to use metal brush just for removing it, it will take you 10 years. You have to, for this kind of railing, you really need to use grinder. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to actually move the grinder on this railing here, just to give them a little bit touch, to remove all the rust from them. See what I'm doing? I'm actually going with this grinder and actually circling around this railing. And that will take it very smooth. You take the russet out and you just smooth it. Let me show you. This railing was not painted for 10 years and I had to remove it because it was rusted and I put it back. And I really want to paint it that it will work at least for 10 years. This is another area. If it's the corner here, it's another area that you actually have. And here you have to actually sand because there are a lot of rusted cumulate here. I'm just checking to see and it looks good. I just need a little bit more here in this area, in this area, in this area. So until the bottom here you need to actually grind. It's important. Here and here there's a lot of accumulation of rusted. We're going to remove it now. Now it looks very smooth and hardly there is any rusted here. Here there is still a little bit. I'm going to remove it now. So this is the result until now. As you can see, it's quite shining. And this is the area I didn't actually grind it here. Still I didn't grind it. Okay, you can see how rusted this is. Let me show you the other railing. Here is the other railing, I didn't even start, so you can see what is going on in the other railing. Okay, look at that. And you can see down also. If I take you down here, you can see how rusted it is. And here, even after I clean it with a brush, iron brush, there is nothing actually move. And look at that here. Look how rusted it is here. In comparison with here, and believe me, that was even worse here. And look the way it's look like. Look the railing, how it's look here. And we go to the other railing, and look at it. Here I started to actually grind, and look at it, nicely look. And that's the way it's look. So that's what I'm saying here. Without grinding, you won't blast it, you have to blast the rusted. Look at the rusted here. Here in this area. And we compare it to here. And you can see how nice it's look. Here is the grinder. Look the way it's look like. This is a disc, grinder disc. DeWalt, I'm going to use now a new one. That's the new one, that's the way it's look like. You really need a couple of them to work with. You put the grinder here. Or the disc of the grinder, and then you just close it. And you close it with this tool. You see, I'm pressing here with this, my thing with my finger, just to make sure it's locked. And then that's it, it's done. I'm continue actually grinding here, this area, with a new grinder. I almost completed grinding here in this railing, and you can see the result. It's very, very different than what it used to be before. The rusted was all over. And that's from one side, I'll show you the other side. Here I really don't need to grind because it looks good. But here I really grinded until the top. And you can see how it's looking in the top. And here also. There are still some spots, very small spots that I'm going to remove with a navy navel gel. I want to show you how I'm going to do it. Let me show you another thing that I would like to do. So here's the way you see it from this direction. As you can see, how much work was invested here. Actually, over 3 hours, I just grinding this area. So you can see how it's look, almost new. And here, the way it looks from here, after I grind most of the things here, there's hardly any rusted left. Okay. Here's the other tools I like to show you. This is a steel brush, okay, but you can see how it looks like. And you need to actually operate it with electrical and not a battery, because you need really high speed to work. And this, what nice in that is you can actually go to places. Sorry about that, but you can go to places, I will show you, that grinder cannot really go. Let me show you how. So you must work with goggles, protection, and mask is also recommended, because you don't want to breathe this rusted stuff. Let me show you how it works. So I can really go with, for places where the grinder cannot go. The grinder is very stronger than this, but still you can remove the rest of the rust from places you can't actually do. Let me show you another place here. Here is another place. That is the tools that you can use in the places where you cannot, the grinder cannot reach. Here is another steel brush. You can see it's a... This one will remove most of the remaining of the rusted from the surface of this metal railing. Let me show you how. I want to show you from cost proximity how does it look after I use it. Close to it, you can see how clean this piece of metal here look like. All the thing that you see, it's actually a paint that's left over, that's nothing. What's important is just to remove most of the rust. And you can use a primer, clean primer on it to paint, to start painting this railing. Here is the result here. And here you can see. And here also. So it's actually a very good result. And after I use a grinder and other iron steel, brass steel, whatever, I'm going to use this. That's the last thing I'm going to use, called Diablo steel dime. And that's actually a grinder plus polishing. So I would like to try it. It's not expensive, you can find it in Home Depot. Okay, so let's see how it works. So I finished to grind here, and really this Diablo, as you can see here, Diablo Demon, okay, which is 60, I believe, 4.5 and 60 cores here, as you can see here, 60 cores, okay, this is the best really grinder and polish I use. It's very strong and it did very, very well. So really, it's the first time I'm using it, but it's really, really good. So now what I'm going to use here, I'm going to use this Neville jelly that actually selling by Loctite. Okay, and that's what I have to do. I have to actually apply it on the surface, leave it for 5 to 10 minutes. Apply it with a brush, leave it for 5 and 10 minutes, and then wash it. Let's see what's going to happen now, because there are some places that have a little bit of rust, so you want to take this rust also. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to pour here quite a bit of jelly. Okay, so you can see here what I have a jelly here. and I'm going to apply it on the metal railing, on the railing, on the iron railing with this brush. So the way I'm going to do it is actually, it's like you painting now. Actually just painting the area here, so I'm actually putting quite a liberal amount of this jelly in the places where there are not the grinder and the sander cannot reach, but also in all the other places, just to remove the rust before I'm actually going to prime it forever, and it will last forever, I believe. It actually smells like a sulfur acid. I'm quite sure there is a sulfur acid inside, some kind of other chemical. Okay, I finished to apply this navel jelly, and I want to show you how it's looked like before I'm going to wash it, because I have to wait like 5 minutes. So let's see. So you can see it's very pinky, and I will put it for like 10 minutes. But look at that, it's already working, start working. You can see how much I put here and here, all the places with this jelly. Okay, and let's see how it's going to look. I let it stay for 10 minutes. Now I'm going to wash it with water. I finished actually cleaning it with water. Let me show you the result. Okay, now you're looking better. Now it's, the picture is nicer because water was going to the camera. So let me show you the result. It looks like new now, really. If you look at that, you don't see any sign of rusted. Okay, here. And we can go here and to show you the result. Here it looks really white. And here there is no really any sign of really rusted. Everything is look very nice before I'm going to put the prime, the clean prime. The other color you see, it's the black color, which is stay here, but it is not rusted really. It's just the previous color. On top of it, I'm going to put the prime also. So we have most of the metal now, it's naked. But our pieces of black color, on that one we're going to paint with prime. You can see the result here also. Excellent result.